Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. As we are dealing with the series of production management, today we are going to see an important topic that is known as the forecasting. Forecasting is being done on the basis of the past data, and on that past data we are going to predict the future. So forecasting is all about predicting the future so that a business should get the optimum uses and profit which he can earn. Now, for forecasting, there are two methods. One is qualitative, the second is quantitative. Today we are going to explore the quantitative forecasting methods. It is one of the most important for any production manager to have a knowledge of these quantitative methods. Now, what is the application of forecasting in production management? Because you all know that production management is all where a product is going to be finalized and it is being produced for the market. So these are the areas in which we are going to apply the forecasting. The first one is supply chain management. As you all know that from the raw material to the finished goods and from that good reaching to the market, everything should be properly organized, and here forecasting is very important in supply chain management, as well as it is very important for economic forecasting, as well as earthquake forecasting, as well as land use forecasting, players and team performance in sports, political forecasting, product forecasting, sales forecasting, technological forecasting, telecommunication forecasting, transport planning and transportation forecasting, weather forecasting, flood forecasting and meteorology. Means forecasting is being used everywhere. Wherever we have to see that what is going to be happening in the future, we are going to take the help of forecasting, because it is a method by which we can predict that what is going to happen in the future course of action. So forecasting is somewhat a tool for all the production manager to take proper decisions on the basis of the past data. So when we talk about the quantitative forecasting methods, there are the six methods which we are going to discuss over here. These six methods are purely dependent on the quantitative data. Means it is being used only and only when we have got the quantitative data. Means the data should be in numerics. The first one is average approach. The second one is Navy approach. Third one is drift method. Fourth is seasonal Navy approach. Fifth one is time series forecasting. And the last one is the causal model. As you all know that these six methods are somewhere or the other is very important tool for a production manager. So let's explore the average approach. So average approach, what is average approach? As you all know that in average we used to take out the mean value, and this mean value is somewhat very important for a manager to understand that this is the value on which we have to work. So whenever a manager has got a mean value and he processes that mean value for predicting the future, we see that it is an average approach. In this approach, the predictions of all the future values are equal to the mean of the past data. Means whatever data you have got, you take out the mean of that data and we see that this is the mean of the data, and we say that is an average of that specific series. This approach can be used with any sort of data, whether past data is available. Means whatever data you have got, if you have got any series, any data, you can apply this method. So it is a very simple method. Whatever past data you have got, you take out the mean of that data and you get the exact value. And according to that value, you have to take a decision that this will be the value on which we have to work. So it is one of the most simple qualitative, quantitative method for the production managers. Now, Navy approach. So it is one step more of the average. Navy approach, that is known as the Navy forecast, are the most cost-effective forecasting method and provide a benchmark against which more sophisticated models can be compared. In time series data, using Navy approach would produce forecasts that are equal to the last observed value. It is one of the most important tool. As you say, it is a cost-effective method and it is a benchmark against which most of the sophisticated tools can be checked. So here, what we used to do is this, that we take out the series, time series, and we take out the average. and closest to the last value, we say that this is the value, and according to we predict the future. So this is the Navy forecast. Now, drift method. Drift by word says that there are certain changes which you can do on the data to get the exact value. Means you are playing with the present data, but you have to take into consideration whatever changes which are being taken place over there. So whatever changes is being taking place in the environment, in the economic conditions, in the government conditions, in the law and all the things, in the taxing systems, you have to take the product of the price of the raw material, the product cost, everything should be considered over here. So why? Because it is somewhat drift which is going to come, and a manager has to take into account all the drift which is being coming. A variation of a Navy method, it is allowed the forecast to increase or decrease over time. Whether the amount of change over time called the drift is said to be the average change seen in the historical data. Means, as I have told you, that it is somewhat important to take out the mean, and whatever the changes which has been taken over the time, we have to accumulate that on the specific data, and we will take out the value on the basis of the historical or the past data which we have. So this third method, drift method, is important when there is a changes on the environmental factor. And whenever there is a changes in the environmental factor, we have to consider the drift method. Now, seasonal Navy approach. As by the name says, that here also we take the mean value, but here seasons is very important, because the demand of the product depends upon the season on which the product is being used. For example, if you are producing a raincoat, so the monsoon is very important for each and every demand of the raincoat in the market. If you are going to sell umbrellas, automatically the monsoon has a direct impact on the sale of umbrella in the market. So here, the seasonal Navy method accounts for seasonality by setting each production to be equal to the last observed value of the same season. Means you have got the seasonal cycle, you take out the value of the seasonal cycle, and on the basis of that seasonal cycle, you are going to calculate the data. So there, the variable which is required is the seasons, and according to that, the demand in the market is being created, and we are going to supply the product as much as the demand in the market. So seasonal approach is somewhere important for the production manager, where the product is being made and is being sold on the basis of the seasons. Time series forecasting. Time series is very important. All the students must have studied time series in business statistics. Time series is a series which is being based on the different time formats. We used to collect the data on the basis of a time. For example, if we divide a year into 12 months, or we divide into year quarterly, or monthly, or half yearly, you have to take the data according to the time series. So here, there is also a base year which we have to take into account. So time series is all about the time and the data you are going to get. If you are going to calculate the data of last past 10 years, so you have to say that from 1994 to 2004 to 2014 to 2024, you have to calculate all the data of 10 years gap. This is a time frame. If you have to take the yearly data, you have to take the data from 2014, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Like this, you come to up to 24, and you take out the data, you take out the mean, and according to that mean, you have to calculate the value. So this is one of the most important tool, because here the time frame is very important. At what time the product is being demanded in the market, and before that demand, the product must be supplied in the market so that the customer can buy the product as per his needs. Now, causal method. As you all know that if there is something happening, it has got an impact on the other factor. If you have got two series, X series and Y series, and one of the series is dependent on the other series, we can say that it has got the causal approach. If we take out the correlation of two things, the most important factor which is being used over there is that the two or more than two series must have certain relationship between them. You cannot take the correlation if the two series are independent to each other. So here, when you have cause and effect relationship, you are going to apply this model. So some forecasting methods try to identify the underlying factors that might influence the variable that is being forecast. Means here it is being saying that there are certain factors which is going to influence the variable, and this is what the impact, cause and effect impact. So for example, including information about the climate pattern might improve the ability of model to predict umbrella sale, right? So if you have got a proper weather report, according to that you are going to get your product ready and supply it to the market. As we talked about the quotes, woolen quotes. So automatically, if you are working in the month of, if you are staying in India, then automatically you have to supply that product in the month of October, November, well before the winter is going to arrive in our country. If you are sitting in US, you have to take the series, time series over there. You have to take the correlation over there. If you are sitting in Pune, you have to take the weather conditions of Pune. If you are sitting in Prayagraj, you have to take the weather conditions of the Prayagraj. So in whatever city you are residing in, you have to take out the weather condition of that specific city. So as a production manager, you have to deal in a specific region. So for a production manager, it is very important that for predicting the forecast, you must have got a proper data of weather. And these climatic change has a direct impact on the sale of a product. If you have got a specific data and a right data, accurate data, automatically your predictions will be up to the mark and there will be no error. So if you have got proper accuracy in the data and forecasting system, automatically you are going to produce and throw the product in the market according to the demand. So it reduces the cost of production also. It reduces the wastage also. It reduces the overburden of product in the warehouses. So forecasting is very important for all the production manager. Now we are going to go into the next method that is known as the causal model includes. Now, there are two methods by which we are going to take out the causal model. The first one is regression. As you all know that regression is one of the most important statistical tools, and this is somewhere a manager has to go in the past data, and according to that past data, he has to go and predict the future. So in regression, you all know there are two series, X and Y. And as a manager, you have to take out the regression between both the series. So there is a two lines which will be there. Regression equation X on Y and regression equation Y on X. So when we are talking about X on Y, we are going to see that you have got the X minus X bar, standard deviation of X, standard deviation of Y, coefficient of correlation is equal to Y minus Y bar. Here, now if you are going to calculate the X series on Y series, you are going to apply this method. But if you are going to take Y on X, you have Y minus Y bar equal to standard deviation of Y minus standard deviation of X coefficient of correlation x minus x bar. So this is the formula by which you are going to calculate the regression. So these two regression equations are very important. On the basis of that, you are going to get the value, right? So whenever we are talking about the regression, we have to deal with these things. Now there is another method which is very important, that is known as autoregressive moving average with exogenous inputs, ARMAX. ARMAX is very important. Why? Because quantitative forecasting models are often judged against each other by comparing their in-sample or out-of-sample measure mean square error, although some researchers have revised against this. Means here, you can say that if you are comparing the in-sample and out-sample, there must have certain errors. Some say that this error should be eradicated, while some says that no, it should not be. So in this method, we remove the error because we are working in the exogenous inputs. So ARMAX model is important when we are going to deal with the past data and we are taking the errors which are being there and removing that error, and we are predicting on the basis of that. So these causal models has two ways in which we can take out. The first one is regression equation, where I have told you upon x on y and y on x, or the ARMAX model, which is also being there. Now, forecasting error. It is also very important. Why? Because there is an error which is always being there. So whenever you are going to calculate the error, there are two values which is being very important. The actual value and the forecasting value. Means the actual value is the value of the series which you are going to get. If you have got x series, there are certain number 10, 15, 20, 25, 56, like this you have got series. You have got y, 25, 35, 46, 40, 42. So you have got this series. So here, there is an actual data you are going to get. You add up this, sum up, and you have got the actual data. And after that, you are taking out the mean. And that mean will be the forecasting value. So there must be an error. Means the gap between the actual error and forecasting is big. So whenever we have to calculate the error over here, that is known as the forecasting error, so we have to take the difference between the actual error and the forecasting error of that specific time. T stands for that specific time. So here E stands for forecasting error of that specific period. Y is the actual value of that specific period, and F is the forecasting value of that specific period. So for taking out the error of the forecasting, that is known as the forecasting error, we have to subtract the data of the forecasting by the actual data. Whatever value you are going to get is the error. It is the forecasting error. So friends, this is all about the forecasting. So quantitative methods is very important for a production manager to get and evaluate the system, to get the proper result. It is very important for a production manager. As a student of production management, you all know all the six methods of this quantitative system, because all the six methods has got its own advantages, and it has been used on the specific term. Some has got certain advantages while the other has got the certain advantages. If seasonal methods you are important for time series, there are average methods which is being used by averaging the data. So it is very important for a production manager to process the raw data into finished good and to produce a specific product which is being needed on the market. So for getting the right product for the right place, the qualitative and the quantitative forecasting method is very important. Qualitative method I have already told you, quantitative method today I have told you. I hope you have explored this and you must have understood this. Thank you.